Well, we are so honoured to have with us right now Dancing with the Stars finalist and all-round truly inspirational woman. Welcome to the cafe, Jess Quinn.
Oh,
just hearing that intro music, it makes me nervous. I feel like I'm about to step out on the stage.
People's choice. It's all over. Can you believe it?
No, I actually can't believe it. It's going to take some time, I think, for it all to sink in that it's over and just the ride that it's been. You know, it's been such an amazing journey. So, yeah, it's going to take a while, I think.
Because
yeah.
People get really depressed after a show or a TV show because yeah. they, you know, they're used to the routine. Well, trust me, I've been on a few shows that have ended. But, yeah, is that how you feel? But sad?
Yeah, I feel really sad. I mean, it's only been a day and I'm already like, do I go to training? Like, I feel like I'm just having a couple of days off and then we'll get back into another dance.
Yeah, have you called Johnny yet?
I have. Pretty much straight after the show, I'm like, hey there.
Hiya. And what did he say to you? See you later.
We're both feeling the same. I mean, he's been through it before. He knows what to kind of expect and it does feel weird after. I mean, we've spent every day together at least 9 hours a day since Easter. So that's a lot of time with someone.
That's a lot of time with somebody. So what was that grand final like for you? Did you have any inkling of how it was going to go?
We had no idea. I mean, the four finalists, we were all backstage and we all said to each other, we're all great friends, and we all said no matter what happens, and we'd all done exactly what we wanted to do, and it was just over to the public, really, and we were all happy with whoever won, and yeah, it's, you know, it was amazing.
Well, and there's sort of, you know, three or four of you that miss out on exit interviews, so to speak, so I'm pleased that we've got you in here, because there is a lot of ground to cover, Jess Quinn. Where do I start? I'm going to start with, how did you feel when they asked you? Did it take much convincing to do it?
It actually did take a little bit of convincing, if I'm honest. I initially said no, just because the thought of learning to dance on national TV, I was like, if I'm going to learn to dance, let's not do it in front of 400,000 people. And, you know, for me, it's a huge physical challenge. I have physical challenges every single day, so the thought of, I just couldn't see how I could physically dance. And so I nearly said no, and then I just realised the opportunity that I had, A, to raise money for my charity, and B, to put myself out of my comfort zone. And, yeah, that's what I did.
Let's talk about your leg, because for those that don't know your story, maybe if they missed it, tell us about how you lost your leg.
Yeah, so I had cancer when I was 9. I went through about 9 months, 12 months of chemotherapy, and then they ended up amputating my leg. So that was 16, nearly 17 years ago now.
How does a 9-year-old process that?
I don't think they do. I mean, my recollection of that time is a bit airy, I guess. It kind of feels like another life, and that's kind of how I look at it. It was my life before I lost my leg, and I mean, it was probably even harder for my family to see me go through that, but I think you get caught up in it, and it is what it is and what's happening at the time.
And your family have got you here now still, as opposed to not having you just
exactly,
around anymore.
Exactly.
So what about when you went back to school? How did the kids react? How did you deal with that?
Yeah, I was really lucky to have an amazing school. I went to a school on the shore where it was really close-knit, and Mum had actually gone in just before I had my surgery, and I actually found this note that she wrote the other day, and it was her little speech that she was giving the kids, and she put, I guess, cancer into terms that 9-year-olds could understand, and I think that really helped. It kind of, they were with me through the whole process, so when I went back to school, it was just this exciting thing. It wasn't, oh, who's this girl? You know, I was just their friend, and they were with me through the whole process, so I was really lucky to have
that. Same girl, just no leg.
Exactly.
And, you know, when you're faced with challenges, I guess, you've overcome them. What has been the driving force behind that?
I think for me, I've always had this attitude where I just wanted to get back up and get on with life,
right.
and I've done that in everything that I've been through, and I did that as a 9-year-old, and I've done that on Dancing with the Stars. You know, I guess it's been my life mission to make the most out of this, I guess, opportunity that I have. You know,
and what about body issues? I guess because, you know, ladies when they're in a beautiful long dress, they must think, oh, that's going to look amazing. With you with no leg, was that stuff that you thought about and had to process?
Yeah, I mean, I struggled a lot with body images as a kid when I was kind of going through my teens, and that's when everyone, I think, starts to struggle with that kind of thing. And I think, yeah, it took a really long time to accept what I'd been through and accept how I looked as a person. And then I don't know, I just kind of found this confidence, and that's part of my mission now, is just to make others feel comfortable in their own skin, because we don't really have any control over what we look like or what we go through. And
which is great, because you're either going to spend your whole life feeling miserable and because of not having a leg,
totally.
Or you're just going to go, hey, this is me now.
Exactly.
This is how it is.
And we all have insecurities, some bigger than others, but we all have them, and it's just a matter of accepting who we are are and making the most of it.
I do have one question about your leg. Mm-hmm. On the final, we saw your natural leg that you offered one dance.
Yes.
Dressed up with fishnets and it had a necklace and everything on. And everyone was doing selfies with us. I saw Roger Farrelly do a selfie with it. Did you get the leg back and is the leg traumatised?
The leg is not traumatised. I'm currently wearing it. It is covered in glitter and the skin on my leg is really sticky, so the glitter coming off is not going to happen. But yeah, that became kind of a bit of a gag backstage. They stole my leg each week and did something funny. So we were like, let's do something big in the finale. And the producers cleared it that we could have it in Sharon's booth. And we were just like, this is amazing.
Well, you didn't get the glitter ball, but you got the glitter leg.
Exactly. So what more do I need?
Okay, so what happens next? You're off to LA.
I am off to LA. A week and a half's time, I'll be on a plane, which is exciting.
And before you go, though, have you gone through that whole feeling? Because I reckon, you know, more and more people know who you are now. So you're right at this point where, you know, you're on a high with New Zealand. Is it somewhat, you know, disappointing that you're leaving now, or are you ready to go?
A bit of both. I'm only going for a short time just because this has been so amazing that I want to come back and just keep pursuing what I'm pursuing here. But yeah, so it's a little bit weird, but it is also weird. I was just coming back from a photo shoot and I must have got stopped about three times going down the street. And I was like, this is weird.
This is great. So what are you going to do in LA?
So I've been signed to a modelling agency up there. So I'm going to pursue this kind of modelling career in the agency that I work, that I'm going to be working with, all about diversity and overcoming body image and kind of getting this this realness out into the world, and that's what I really want to be a part of. So I'm working with them on that and a bit of speaking. Speaking is kind of one of my biggest goals over the next while. I really want to get into motivational speaking and
Well, you're good at it.
I know, here we go. I think you're just good at everything. Okay, anyway, look, quickly before time is up, any romance in the show behind the scenes?
No, who are you talking
about? Come on. No, I was just curious.
Listen to that, button lit.
Yeah. Did Sam deserve to win?
Everyone deserved to win. Sam definitely deserved to win. We all worked so hard and, yeah, it was anyone's game. And literally everyone who was on that show deserved to win.
What's one thing that happened that none of us know about yet? Did you injure Johnny? Was there something that happened that no one's talked about yet?
Yeah, that rap party.
Okay. Let's not talk about the rap party. No, what did... Oh, there's a lot of things. I can't even think of anything right now.
Actually, we're out of time. Hey, well, thank you so much.
You've been saved.
Absolutely.
Thank you so much for coming in.
Thank you.
If you missed Sunday's Dancing with the Stars Grand Final, then you can catch up on that or any other episodes that you missed on 3Now.